Next, the third subdivision, 6x square minus 3 minus 7x. Look carefully, it is not in standard form. First, we have to write this in standard form. So, it can be rewritten as x square term, then x term, and finally the constant term. Okay. So, the given polynomial is 6x square minus 7x minus 3. Let the value of the polynomial to be 0. Then I have to find the factors for 16 to minus 3, minus 18. So, I have to find the factors for minus 18. Here it is minus 7. So, I am going to split it as minus 9 plus 2. Okay, so, minus 9 into plus 2 gives minus 18. Minus 9 plus 2 gives minus 7. So, 6x square minus 7x can be written as plus 2x minus 9x. Taking out 2x as common, I will get 3x plus 1, and here taking minus 3 as common, 3x plus 1. First writing this term, 2x minus 3 into, then writing the common terms, 3x plus 1. 2x minus 3 is equal to 0, 2x is equal to 3, x is equal to 3 by 2, which is one of the 0. Here 3x plus 1 is equal to 0, 3x is equal to minus 1, x is equal to minus 1 by 3, it is the another 0. So, let me substitute alpha is equal to 3 by 2 and beta is equal to minus 1 by 3. Then comparing the given polynomial to standard form, A will be x square coefficient, it is 6. B is x coefficient, it is minus 7. And C is the constant term, it is minus 3. Okay. Consider the first condition, it is sum of zeros, that is alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. We have to verify this condition. First consider the LHS, alpha plus beta, that is 3 by 2 plus of minus of 1 by 3. So, which is 3 by 2 minus 1 by 3. Taking 6 as LCM, I will get 9 minus 2, which is equal to 7 by 6. Consider the RHS, minus b by a. So, minus b by a is minus b value. So, it is minus of minus 7 by a value 6. So, which is 7 by 6. Thus, LHS is equal to RHS. First condition is verified. Then the second condition, product of zeros, that is alpha into beta is equal to C by A. Consider the LHS, alpha into beta. Alpha into beta is 3 by 2 into minus 1 by 3. 3 by 2 into minus 1 by 3. So, which is equal to minus 3 by 6. Can be simplified as minus 1 by 2. Then consider the RHS, C by A, C value is minus 3, A value is 6. So, it is minus 3 by 6. This can be simplified as minus 1 by 2. Thus, LHS is equal to RHS. Second condition is also verified. Then the fourth subdivision, 4u square plus 8u. Let substitute the value of the polynomial to be 0 for finding the zeros of the polynomial. So, I am taking 4u as common, I will get u plus 2 is equal to 0. So, separately equate to 0, I will get 4u is equal to 0 and u plus 2 is equal to 0. Here u is equal to 0 and then here u is equal to minus 2. So these are the zeros of the polynomial 4u square plus 8u. Let's substitute alpha is equal to 0, beta is equal to minus 2. Then comparing the polynomial to standard form, a, the x square coefficient, it is 4, b, the x coefficient, here it is 8, c, the constant term, here there is no constant term, so c value is 0. Okay. So these are the values I am going to use in these conditions. Consider the first condition, sum of zeros, that is alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. So alpha value is 0 plus beta value is minus 2. So which is 0 minus 2 minus 2. So LHS is minus 2. Then consider the RHS, minus b by a. So b value is 8, this is minus 8 by a value 4, minus 8 by 4 gives minus 2, thus LHS is equal to RHS, first condition is verified. Then consider the second condition, product of the zeros, that is alpha into beta is equal to c by a. Consider the LHS, alpha value 0 into beta value minus 2, 0 into minus 2 gives 0, this is the LHS. Then RHS, c by a, so c value is 0, a value is 4, so 0 by 4 gives 0, thus LHS is equal to RHS, second condition is also verified. Next, the fifth subdivision, t square minus 15, let's substitute the value of the polynomial to be 0 for finding the zeros of the polynomial. T square minus 15 is equal to 0, then taking 15 to the right side, it will become plus 15, t square is equal to 15. Now take square root on both sides. So I will get t is equal to plus or minus root 15. So either t is equal to plus root 15 or t is equal to minus root 15. These are the zeros of the given quadratic polynomial. Let's substitute alpha value is equal to root 15, then beta value is equal to minus root 15. Then comparing this to standard form, the value of a will be 1. The value of b is 0 because there is no x term, and the value of c is minus 15, the constant term. Okay. Here consider the first condition, sum of zeros, that is alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. Consider the LHS, alpha plus beta, that is plus root 15 plus minus root 15. So it is root 15 plus of minus root 15, which is plus root 15 minus root 15, it will be cancelled and it will be 0. Then RHS, minus b by a, here it is minus 0 by 1, which is 0, right? So LHS is equal to RHS, thus the first condition is verified. Then go for the second one, product of the zeros, alpha into beta is equal to c by a. Consider the LHS, alpha into beta, that is root 15 into minus root 15, root 15 into minus root 15, root 15 into root 15 gives 15, plus into minus gives minus, so it is minus 15. Consider the RHS, c by a, so the value of c minus 15 and the value of a is 1, so minus 15 by 1 gives minus 15. Thus, LHS and RHS are equal. So, the second condition is also verified. Next, the sixth subdivision, 3x square minus x minus 4. So, you have to find the zeros of the given quadratic polynomial. Let the value of the polynomial be 0. Okay. Then using the splitting the middle term method, I have to find the factors for 3 into minus 4, that is minus 12. You have to find the factors for minus 12, and if we add those two factors, I have to get the coefficient of the x term. Here the coefficient of x term is minus 1. So I am splitting minus 12 as plus 3 and minus 4. When I multiply plus 3 and minus 4, I will get minus 12. And I am adding plus 3 and minus 4, I will get minus 1. So, I am splitting the middle term minus x as plus 3x minus 4x. Okay. Then taking 3x as common from these two terms, I will get 3x into x plus 1, and minus 4 from these two terms, I will get x plus 1. Then writing this term 3x minus 4, and then writing the common term x plus 1. 3x minus 4 is equal to 0, 3x is equal to 4, x is equal to 4 by 3, which is one of the 0, and x plus 1 is equal to 0, so which means that x is equal to minus 1. This is the another 0. So, let me substitute. The alpha value is equal to 4 by 3 and beta value is equal to minus 1. Then comparing the polynomial to the standard form of the quadratic polynomial, I will get the value of a, that is x square coefficient. Here it is 3. So, a value is 3 and x coefficient b value, it is minus 1, and the constant term here it is minus 4, c value is minus 4. Okay. Then the relation between the zeros and the coefficients are sum of zeros is equal to minus coefficient of x term divided by the coefficient of x square term. Okay. So, here sum of the zeros, that is alpha plus beta, alpha plus beta is equal to minus coefficient of x term. Here the coefficient of x term is b, so it is minus b. Then the coefficient of x square term is a. We have to prove alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. Let us consider the LHS. Alpha plus beta, that is alpha value is 4 by 3 and beta value is minus 1. So, plus of minus 1. It can be written as 4 by 3 minus 1. Then taking 3 as LCM, I will get 4 minus 3 by 3, which is equal to 1 by 3. Then consider the RHS, it is minus B by A. The B value here is minus 1, so it is minus of minus 1 by A value is 3, so which is equal to 1 by 3. Thus LHS is equal to RHS. The sum of the zeros is equal to minus coefficient of x term by coefficient of x square term. Condition is proved. Then the second condition is that product of zeros is equal to the constant term divided by coefficient of x square. Okay. So, it is alpha into beta is equal to constant term is c and the coefficient of x square is a. We have to prove alpha into beta is equal to c by a. Let us substitute the values. Taking the LHS, it is alpha into beta. So alpha value is 4/3 and beta value is -1. So 4/3 × -1 is equal to -4/3. Then consider the RHS C by A. So C by A, C value is -4, A value is 3. So it is -4/3. Thus LHS is equal to RHS. The second condition, product of zeros is equal to constant term divided by coefficient of x square condition is proved. Okay.